Williams, I'm recently a retired police officer, but I've been with the department for close to 27 years. And my wife, Amanda Williams, works here at Dallas State University. She and I have been married for 28 years. I have three kids, Ronnie and Cheryl, Miranda Laverne, and Renaldus Williams, Jr. You notice, although I've got my name in it, because I want them to be an aged person. If any of you know me, you know what my passion has always been. I love kids. It has been my given duty to tear down as many jails as I possibly can. And I've done this by mentoring kids from ages 4 to up to the early 20s. So I want to continue that in my bid to city council. Any questions?
So I have two questions that were just handed to me from the audience. So the first question, my friend, is with increasing traffic congestion in Valdosta, what is your position on public transportation?
I have visited places before that had public transportation. I think it works well. If we go to this public transportation system and have it where people can afford it, make it affordable easily like they did with Jackson and some areas, it would decrease the traffic that's in Valdosta. I was recently telling the person this month ago, I was born and raised here. I remember going from my house to the mall in 10 minutes. Now that's like 25, 30 minutes. If we can get some of these traffic, the cars off the road, not only would it help the flow of traffic go better, but it also help the environment that all the carbon monoxide that comes from the cars.
And I have a second question from our audience. Lowndes County and the Valdosta metropolitan area have a sizable Hispanic migrant population. What is your position on the issue of immigration, and what will you do to protect these people from exploitation and discrimination?
Thank you so much, whoever just asked that question. Part of my responsibility when I was a police officer was community-oriented policing. One of the things I had the most problem with is trying to reach the Hispanic community. So often they are victims of crime and afraid to call the police department because they think we're going to put them in jail or send them away or try to get them out. That was totally not the thing that we wanted in our police department. So what I did was I met a Hispanic lady. I spoke with her about trying to get the Hispanic community to come to the tactical. Part of that thing we did was we had a meeting. I'll guarantee you maybe 300 Hispanic people showed up at this meeting. We had a meeting on Conley Avenue with one of the churches. And what I did then, I tried to tell those folks that law enforcement, we are not here to put you in jail unless you committed a crime before. But we are not here to persecute you about where you're from, how you got here, what's here. We want you to know that we are here to protect you. You let me sit in council, I guarantee you this, I can tell you this right now. I'm going to make sure that not only our Hispanic community is protected, but everyone else's right is protected. I do not want to see anybody become the victim of any type of crime and afraid to call police officers because they're afraid of us prosecuting them where they can.
And I have one final question from the audience. As you say, your passion is children. Have you thought about running for the school board?
I have not thought about running for the school board. City council, it has been a thing that I always wanted to do. I think doing that city council thing, I can continue to do stuff that I normally do with kids. I'm going to continue to shop for the cop program. We're going to continue to draw education and the youth program. I'm going to continue those type of things. Something else I'm also putting in consideration, I'm not familiar with but also having a chapter of Big Brother Big Sister program. So I'm going to contact someone to see how can we get that started here in Valdosta.
Okay.